in search of cleaner fuel for aviation, a scientific balloon campaign in Antarctica, and a key engine test for our Artemis Moon rocket. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. NASA and Boeing partnered recently to conduct a contrail research campaign. During the campaign, NASA's DC-8 Flying Science Laboratory measured emissions in contrail ice formations from a Boeing eco-demonstrator aircraft as the Boeing plane switched between 100% sustainable aviation fuel and a low-sulfur version of conventional jet fuel. Data collected will help determine whether sustainable aviation fuels help reduce the formation of contrails, which may trap heat in the atmosphere. The scientific balloon flights planned during NASA's annual Antarctic Long Duration Balloon Campaign include the Gusto mission. This astrophysics mission is aiming for a record 55-plus day flight in the skies above the southernmost hemisphere. It will map a large part of the Milky Way galaxy, including the galactic center and the nearby Large Magellanic Cloud. Learn more about NASA's scientific balloon program at nasa.gov/scientificballoons. On November 29th, our Stennis Space Center conducted a hot fire test of an RS-25 engine. Crews gimbaled or pivoted the RS-25 around a central point during the test. Gimbaling is a key capability for the engine that is used to stabilize the Space Launch System, or SLS rocket, during flight on Artemis missions to the Moon and beyond. This was the third hot fire in the current 12 test certification series. 70 teams representing 24 states and Puerto Rico were selected to compete in the 2024 Student Launch Challenge. The 9-month-long competition, which requires students to design, build, and fly a high-powered amateur rocket and scientific payload, culminates with final events April 10th through 14th, 2024, near our Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more about what else we're up to, check out nasa.gov.